The Lamborghini. There are times in life when even your dreams can be outdone by what really happens. It is with great pleasure that I relate to you this tale of irony. Now, let me begin by going back to an experience I had as a Cub Scout. I was 8 years old, and it was the day before the annual Pinewood Derby. We'd been instructed to design a race car from a small block of wood and then race it against others at the Derby. Trophies would be given out for the most creative, the funniest, etc. Well, my dad, bless his heart, had all the right intentions when he helped me that evening, and after working on it with limited wood carving tools, my car looked like, well, nothing to write home about. We ended up painting it with some leftover enamel from a shelf my dad had made for my mom. It was pink. So there we went, to the Pinewood Derby. The funny thing is, I didn't think the car looked that bad. I liked it. That was until I saw all the others. Can you say Batmobile? Is it possible to feel proud and embarrassed at the same time? I did. We came home with nothing more than our pride and a pink car. Well, years later, history repeated itself, sort of. Once again, it was the night before the annual Pinewood Derby, but this time I was the dad, and I was determined to give it our best shot. We decided to go for funny instead of fast. And after searching the internet for ideas, my son Michael, who was 7 at the time, chose the Oscar Mayer Wienermobile. Excellent choice. 6-year-olds and I think alike. It ended up being a family project. Our older son Joseph helped with the details, and every few minutes Michael would run in and get Mom's approval. After much carving, sanding, and painting, this time I made sure we had all the right tools, we were finished. And if I do say so myself, we'd done a pretty darn good job. Michael liked it, and that's all that matters. And no one would be embarrassed. It was with great pride that we walked into the school gym. The same electricity I had experienced as a boy was in the air, and the excitement in Michael's eyes told me how special this was. Suddenly, I was a Cub Scout all over again. We checked in, and Michael placed his car next to all the others. Now, most had been built for speed. After all, this was a race. Michael's group was the first to compete, and you can imagine the looks on our faces when the Wienermobile won the first heat, and the next, and the next. With every win, our family laughed with disbelief. Then there were only 3 cars left. 2 of them looked like race cars. The other was shaped like a weenie. The weenie won. Without meaning to, we had built the fastest car in my son's division. On the way home, Michael read the inscription over and over. First place, division champion. He held it tightly in his right hand. In his left hand was his other trophy, which read, Funniest Car. When life gives you another chance, go for it.